This video seeks to give an overview of RECD in Audioscan equipment and to highlight recent changes and improvements. For detailed, model-specific instructions and help with subjects such as connection, probe tube placement, and speech map operation, please consult the user guide for your system available on our website. The RECD, or real ear to coupler difference, is a measurement across frequencies of the output of a sound transducer in the fixed volume of a coupler, subtracted from the output of the same transducer in the unknown volume of a closed ear canal. Since the SBL produced in a closed space varies with volume and impedance, the RECD can be used as a characterization of the acoustics of the measured ear canal. The measured RECD can then be used for two purposes. One, to correct and convert HL thresholds to the SBL format used by many fitting methods and real ear approaches. Audiometers are calibrated to an average adult ear canal. Any differences in volume and impedance will be reflected in the measured hearing levels. Using a measured RECD ensures that the SBL thresholds accurately capture the true level of hearing sensitivity for the patient in question. Two, to allow hearing instrument fitting in the test box. The RECD is applied to the coupler microphone measurement so that hearing instrument performance in the coupler can be predictive of performance in the real ear. RECD starts with a calibration of the transducer in the coupler. This measurement can be stored weekly and will expire every Monday morning. On the Axiom, RM500SL, and Legacy Verifit products, this is done by connecting the transducer to the 2cc HA2 or BTE coupler. RECDs are now expressed in HA1 referenced values, but we use the HA2 for coupling convenience and convert this automatically in software. Select Calibrate Transducer. Once stabilized, the green calibration curve is captured and stored. If it expires, you'll be prompted to remeasure. On the Verifit 2, the RECD must extend to 12.5 kHz to accommodate high-frequency speech map, so it's been renamed WRECD, or Wideband RECD. The transducer calibration is performed using the 0.4cc wideband coupler and the TRIC, or Thin Tube RIC adapter. The RECD measurement on the ear is made using a probe microphone. As with all real ear measurements, the ear canal is first checked through otoscopic examination for obstructions and to ensure correct probe tube placement. Position the probe tube so that the tip is within 5 mm of the tympanic membrane. Connect a foam ear tip to the RECD transducer and, without moving the probe tube, carefully insert to the standard depth and ensure enough time passes for the foam to fully expand. The personal ear mold can be substituted for the foam ear tip in the real ear measurement to capture the tubing characteristics in subsequent applications of the measured RECD. Note that in the audiometry entry window, there is a selection for the transducer used in the HL measurement and a separate one for the coupling type used in the RECD measurement. It is important to specify when using an ear mold for RECD. However, for ear molds where the total tubing length is less than 35 mm, we recommend you select foam ear tip so a more appropriate correction is applied. When using an ear mold for the RECD measurement, be sure to block vents at the medial end. Lubrication can be used to aid in a proper seal. Select Measure Real Ear. On screen, the real ear measurement will be shown as a magenta curve. When that stabilizes, it is captured and stored, and the RECD or WRECD will be automatically generated as a blue curve. The dotted line represents an average age-specific RECD. Since the volume of a 2cc coupler is much greater than that of an ear canal, the SBL in the coupler will be much lower than that measured in the ear, and the resulting RECD values always positive. A negative RECD in the low frequencies will normally indicate a poor seal during the on-ear measurement. However, it should be noted that this can also result from a perforation of the TM or a PE tube in place. If the RECD curve is more than 10 dB different from the average, it is suggested that you check for probe tube placement issues or blockage and remeasure. WRECD, the wideband RECD measured on the Verifit 2, also includes values at 8, 10, and 12.5 kHz. It's measured using the 0.4 cc coupler, which is much closer in volume to that of an ear canal. As a result, an average WRECD will typically have values below zero, and negative numbers are not unexpected. However, a leak in the on-ear measurement will still result in a steep roll-off in the low frequencies. The ANSI S3.46 2013 standard advises that the RECD should be a property of the ear alone and not dependent on the sound source and coupling method. To this end, an HA1 referenced RECD is preferable. On Axiom, RM500SL, and Legacy Verifit VF1, measured RECDs are expressed as HA1 referenced. This will be labeled as such on printouts and when storing in NOAA. When entering previously measured values, the coupler reference will be prompted for. Choose HA1 when the RECD was measured on current software or on Verifit 2. Choose HA2 if measured on legacy software. The Verifit 2 will always measure and use a 0.4 cc WRECD. But for compatibility purposes, an HA1 referenced RECD will be calculated automatically. This can be used in cases where the RECD will be entered in other equipment. When entering previously measured values on the Verifit 2, the coupler reference must be selected. HA1 for other models using current software, HA2 for older software, and 0.4 cc for re-entering WRECD measured on the Verifit 2. To ensure full compatibility between Audioscan models, we recommend visiting our website and updating all equipment to the latest released software. For more detailed information on the RECD and WRECD changes, please refer to the current user guide and these documents available on our website.